So I guess all our Dharma brothers and sisters are quite familiar with KT Park. So allow me to just do a very quick introduction for our Zen teacher tonight. So Miss KT Park, Chitoposanim, has begun practicing Zen in 1999, received inka from Zen Master Dae Bong at Musangsa in Korea in 2016. She's currently the administrative director of Musangsa, coordinator of the International Initiative Project for the Global Kwan Im School of Zen, and co-lead for the Seoul in Daejeon Zen Group with her husband, Andrzej Stec JDPSN. 各位同修大家晚上好，我相信大家都对我们今晚的指导老师非常熟悉的，我大概为大家做一个很扼要的一个介绍啊。我们今晚的指导老师呢是易花指导老师，他于1999年开始学禅，2016年受的大风禅师印可成为指导老师。他是现任韩国无上寺的行政总监及国际观音禅宗的国际自发计划总协调，同时他与波兰 Andrzej Stec JDPSN 共同指导观音禅院首尔及大田的禅修活动，我们掌声鼓励。
Hello everyone.
大家晚上好。
Nice to see you again.
很高兴见到各位。
Some of you I practiced together last 2 weeks.
有些同修两个礼拜前一起共修。
So, today's topic is dealing with stress.
今天的我们的讨论的话题呢是如何面对压力。
You know the very well-known American writer,Mark Twain said, for human being, two most important days exist.
那个美国著名的作家 Mark Twain, 他有个有个说法，就是人有两样最重要的东西，两个日子。
The first is the day you were born.
一个日子是你出生的日子。
And the second most important day for a human being is the day you find out why.
第二个很重要的日子是你发觉到为什么的日子。
So that means the day we find out, well, when we're born, we pop out.
当我们出世的时候，我们就只是从我们的娘胎跑出来。
So already appear.
已经出现了。
But the most important second day is the day we find out why I'm alive.
然后更重要就是第二个重要的日子，也就是当你自己去反问说我为什么到这个世界。
So our Zen Master Sung San would ask us always, why do you eat every day?
崇山禅师也时常问他的同学，就是说你为什么每天都要吃饭。
So that's the same question as, why am I alive? What's my life for?
也就是说，为什么我们活着？我们活着是为了什么
？So this kind of question is forcing us to look at the direction of our life.
这些问题呢，逼着我们去看我们人生的方向。
So what is stress?
所以什么是压力
？So everybody have a busy day today.
每个人相信今天都很忙吧
？Okay, tired.
累吗
？No，
不会吗
？Energy， have energy。
有没有能量
？You eat some dinner？
有吃晚餐吗？
Already?
吃了吗
？Did you drink enough water today？
有喝足够的水吗
？How much sleep you had today？
有足够的睡眠吗
？Enough？
足够吗
？Who didn't sleep enough？
有谁睡不够
？Don't be shy 。
不要害羞。
Okay。Anybody exercise today？
有没有人今天运动
？No. Okay.
没有。
Do you know how long you spend looking at your phone?
你们知道你们一天花多少时间在你们的手机上吗
？Any idea?
有没有概念
？So, recently I heard one study of young children watching mobile phone, especially at night.Like, let's say after dinner, yeah?
最近指导老师呢看到 一则文章啊，那文章有说到小孩子在饭后观看手机的一个事项。
So it turns out that most young children, when they are looking at their phone or playing video games in the evening, let's say 2 hours, 1, 2, 3 hours before bed.
就是这个文章有提到说小孩子就在睡觉前的一两个小时，如果他玩手机的话。
By the time they are doing this from 7, 8 years old.Then by the time they are 13, they have depression.
如果他们在那个他小孩子七八岁的时候呢，就开始这个实验了。所以当他到13岁的时候呢，他们发觉小孩子有抑郁症。
So from just a very basic medical point of view, it's because of the blue light from the screen.
所以一个很简单的一个科学的说法呢，就是说那个手机呢在放射出那个蓝色的光。
So the light is actually destroying.The brain function to actually be able to, for the neurons to grow properly in the young person, like a child. Okay.
所以在一个幼小的一个小孩子的脑细胞呢，因为有那个蓝色光线的发射呢，所以导致他的那个脑细胞不能正常的成长。
So stress is something that comes to us in many different ways. Okay.
所以那个。压力呢也在我们的生命中以不同的方式呈现在我们生活中。
But there's a wonderful teaching. It says, without pressure, diamond cannot appear.
如果没有那个千年的一个那个压力的话呢，那个石头也成不了钻石。
That's very interesting. You know, diamond is the hardest jewel in the world, right?
这非常有意思，因为钻石呢是最坚硬的一个矿物。
So to make the clearest, most strong diamond, it needs a lot of pressure. Okay.
所以需要最清澈、最坚硬的一个钻石呢，你就需要最多的压力。
So actually, as human beings, having what we call stress is not a good or bad thing.
所以我们人类呢有压力呢不是件好事也并不是件坏事。
So your body experience stress even through exercise. You stress your body, you move your muscle, you force your muscle to do activity, you force your bones to move, okay? Even your brain, you make your brain function by studying, exercising the muscle of your brain. It actually helps us grow.
就无论是乃至是你运动还是你读书，这都会强迫着你的脑细胞啊，还是你身上的肌肉啊，或者骨髓啊，接受点压力，然后通过这些压力呢，你的身体的肌肉呢，跟你的头脑呢，都会成长。
Yeah, so human body is meant to be moving and doing actions.
所以我们人的身体呢，是希望是一直需要移动，然后同时也是需要做一些行动的。
So, stress is not bad.
所以压力不是件坏事。
But the problem that most of us obviously experience is the overwhelm of stress.
但是我们人往往都会遇到一个问题呢，就是过多的压力。
So, great master said, difficulties are our spiritual teachers.
有大德呢就说到呢，就是越艰难的苦呢，其实就是成就我们的。
Yeah. Inside every difficulty appearing in our life is a diamond.
在我们生命中的每个困难呢，就是说好比我们生命中出现的钻石一般。
But when we cannot take the pressure of this obstacle or karma or stress, as we call it.
当我们不能接受这个压力的同时的当儿呢？
Then everything breaks down. Yeah.
当我们不能接受这个压力或者业力的时候呢，我们可能就会崩溃。
So the breakdown happens in three different ways.
我们的那个我们就崩溃呢，是以三种方式而崩溃。
So first is a physical stress.
第一个呢，就是我们身体上的压力。
So when we look at anything happen to us, you know, some even you have a car accident.
就好比说，我们有时候遇到车祸
，body sickness，
我们身体生病了。
Your husband have an affair.
我的老公有外遇。
Your children give you headache.
小孩子给我头痛。
Our parents pressure us, get married, or why don't you make enough money, or what are you doing with your life? You know, all these things become obstacles.
所以也有可能是我们父母催婚，或者是问到赚多点钱，还是你在生命做些什么，诸如此类的很多种的压力。
So everything in environment, condition, relationship has effect.
无论是环境、诸多的因缘，还是都会造成我们有压力。
But when our senses and our five skandhas, our consciousness and our body are not in harmony, all those things become kind of like a break our rhythm. Okay.
如果我们的眼耳鼻舌身意呢，它都不协调呢，那外在的一些干扰呢，就会让我们的身体崩溃。
So physically, that is when we have a physical low energy. That means you can look at your life and see, did I eat well today?
所以你可以问自己，我今天吃得好吗？
Did I sleep okay today?
我今天休息好了吗？
How do I move my body today?
今天我怎么运动我的身体了吗？
If you have a desk job and you're in front of the computer 10-12 hours a day and you don't move,
如果你在电脑前面工作呢，然后整天10-11个小时不动的话呢，
then definitely you will have a kind of stress.
那你或多或少都会有点问题。
I explained this actually I think last time I was here about how that works because human brain is designed to have this very ancient function of what we call flight or fight. Yeah.
所以其实因为我们人类的头脑呢，我们其实都有一种比较原始的一种本能啊。在这个原始的本能呢，我们都是不然我们就是在一个情况上可以展翅高飞，不然的话呢，我们就有一种逃跑的现象。
So long time ago, human being didn't eat rice 3 times a day.
我很久以前呢，人呢是一天不吃三餐的。
Yeah, maybe they eat once every couple of days or 3, even maybe whole week cannot eat. And you know, you find some fruit or some bush or sometime maybe kill animal, and sometime can animal come and eat you.
所以人呢，以前呢可能就是好几天才吃上一顿啊，然后我们可能就是吃野菜、野果，或者是有时候呢就会杀生吃动物，然后或者是有时候又被动物吃掉。
Yeah, so then if the animal is chasing you, what you do?
所以当那个动物要追着你跑的时候，你怎么办
？Tiger chase you, what you do?
老虎追你怎么办
？Huh? Run very fast.
很快的逃跑。
Run for your life.
为你生命而奔跑吧。
You have to run faster than the tiger not to be eaten, okay?
你要赶快逃命才不会被老虎吃掉。
So that moment, our stress hormone kick in, then running, okay?
所以那个瞬间呢，我们那个压力的那个荷尔蒙呢，就释放了出来。
Become very alert, wake up.
就整个人很精神。
Okay? So sometimes we sit, meditation, retreat, you wake up,Mind very clear. Same kind of wake up, okay?
有时候你在那个闭关的时候呢，坐了很久呢，突然间就是清醒过来的话呢，其实，你就发觉到你的心是很清明的。
So stress hormone is called cortisol, and it's designed to alert you to survive. It's like life and death situation, yeah.
所以那个压力的荷尔蒙呢，会刺激你的身体，让你的身体呢，在生死关头呢，就比较精神些。
But where is your tiger now?
但是你的现在的生命中有是否有还有老虎吗
？Is it your boss?
是你老板吗
？He eat you?
你老板会吃掉你吗
？Or maybe your colleagues? They always like checking you and making trouble.
还是你的同事整天在你的后面说长道四的
？Or maybe it's like 100 emails when you come to office. You open your email box. I have to deal with all these headaches. Yeah.
又或者是你上班的时候呢，你看到有100封未阅读的一个email， 所以你可能就头痛了。
Or maybe you have you make choices and you spend your whole day eating, shopping, you know, yakking, spending, and doing all kinds of things to tire out your desire mind. Yeah.
又或者是呢，你呢每天呢就是忙着吃啊、喝啊、花钱、购物、玩乐，就是为了让你的那个贪欲的心呢得到满足。
Yeah. You know, many, many reasons why we are not comfortable.
许许多多的原因让我们感到不适。
Yeah. So, we are not being chased by tiger, but actually most people nowadays in modern society have a raised cortisol nonstop, all day long.
所以跟原始人相比呢，我们没有被老虎追着，但是我们城市人的那个压力的荷尔蒙呢，其实是过高的。
So very common, we get anxiety.
所以我们呢，有时候会很焦虑。
Insomnia.
睡不着，就是失眠。
Then insomnia and anxiety continue get depressed because not enough energy, not enough rest.
所以那个持续的失眠跟焦虑呢，就会导致你有抑郁症啊，因为抑郁症呢，就是来自于你没有足够的能量。
Then brain kind of burn out.
你的头脑呢已经是过于劳累了。
Then brain burnout, then emotional imbalance.
你的头脑呢就过于劳累呢，那你的情绪就不协调。
Then physical imbalance follow, then sickness appear.
接着呢，身体也会跟着不协调，导致你慢慢的就会生病了。
Okay, then cells break up and then disease. Okay.
你的细胞就开始分解，然后你的病症就上来了。
But the seed, it's very important for us to understand there's a seed of all this.
我们要很清楚的，就是我们现在这样子发生的现象呢，其实都有个种子。
So it means inside, without even us consciously being aware, there's a seed of all of these things from the outside become part of our response. So.Way we react, the way we respond, the way we deal with or don't deal with whatever is appearing is the trigger for all the suffering appearing.
所以其实我们心中呢都有一颗种子哦，然后到我们外界呢跟我们的身心有个触动的时候呢，无论是我们怎么样的反应或者是没有反应，都会导致我们有这样的一个压力的情况。
So Zen Master Sung San said, Don't bother with the branches, but go for the root.
所以那个崇山禅师呢，就常提到啊，就是那种枝末的细节不要去管，直接针对这个根。
So outside situation always will appear.
外境呢，永远都会不断的变化产生的。
But more important is what is the root.
更重要的是，你要追究于那个根。
Who is experiencing this discomfort?
谁在体验这样的不适？
Yeah, who is experiencing this stress?
谁在体验这样的压力？
And where does the stress come from?
这压力又源自于何处呢？
Yeah, so physically, you understand your life pattern, your situation.
身体方面呢，你很知道你的生活习惯跟规律。
So, diet.
可能就是饮食注意一些
，sleep and exercise，
睡觉跟运动
，movement，
就是运动行走
，can help our original energy be sustained or improve，
让我们原本的那个能量呢能进步。
Yeah， that means take care of this physical form。Yeah，
也就是说呢，我们要好好的照顾我们的色身。
The second is so that's physical.Energy. Second, emotional center, our heart center.
第二个就是要注意我们的那个心。
So emotional center is related to physically our breath.
我们的那个心呢，也就是我们情感的中心呢，跟我们的呼吸呢有很大的关联。
How do you breathe when you are stressed, anxious?
如果你压力焦虑的时候，你怎么呼吸？
Like up here, you know, from the upper chest, okay?
你的呼吸是集中在你的胸口的上端。
Last week, this I'm from Korea, South Korea, and North Korean dictator came here, Kim Jong-un. He met with Trump, you remember? Yeah, it seems like years ago already for me.
所以上个礼拜呢，朝鲜的领袖呢金正恩呢就来到这里，跟来到新加坡跟美国总统川普呢有来了一次会谈，然后仿佛就是隔世啊，好像很久了。
I don't know if you notice on TV because I only saw on TV, but this Kim Jong Un, you know, he's very young. I think he's not even 30 or 31, maybe 29 or 30 or something. He's very young.
所以之后老师在电视上看到了那次的会谈啊，然后那次的会谈呢，他发觉到金正恩其实很年轻，要不就是29，要不就是30岁左右。
But he's kind of fat, right?
但是他很胖。
I'm not saying this to criticize him. I'm just saying he's fat because the reason is because he want to look like his grandfather, the first dictator of North Korea, who was bigger and taller.
其实他很胖，但是指导老师的用意呢，不是为了要嘲讽他，而是呢，其实他指出的就是金正恩呢，其实他就是为了要得到他的朝鲜第一代的那个领袖呢，他的祖父的那样的威严，让人家对他的祖父有个联想，所以故意把自己吃得比较胖，比较威严。
So he make himself more fat and kind of look like very powerful. He take many medicine, you know, to be like this. And if you watch him on TV.I watch on CNN, he breathes like this. Cannot breathe. Not healthy, you know.
所以金正恩呢，他其实甚至会服用那个药物啊，让自己变得更臃肿一些。然后你看呢，这个指导老师呢，在那个美国电台CNN 的时候呢，观看金正恩的时候，发觉到他呼吸呢其实是很喘的。
Yeah. So, when you have stress, I said before,This stress hormone appear when the brain gets the message live or die.
所以你的身体呢，当有这个压力的荷尔蒙的时候呢，你就会想说，不就是生就是死，所以你就会比较紧张。
So tiger not chasing you, but in your office or in society, my boss not happy with what I do, maybe he fire me. Then life and death situation appear.In our brain.
当你在办公室的时候呢，可能没有老虎，但是你整天会担心你老板会把你炒掉，所以这样子的情况呢，就会产生一个生和死的问题。
So we sit at our desk in front of our computer, but inside is like life and death, constantly stress, nonstop. Many people, this is everyday life situation right now.
所以甚至其实我们的老板呢，可能真的没有这样的问，我们的生活中没有老虎呢，但是我们整天坐在电脑前面感受这样的压力呢，这样不停的一种体验生跟死的这样的一个瞬间呢，相信很多新加坡人都体验到。
So that moment, very important, come back to your breath. Slowly breathing in, slowly breathe out, okay?
所以那个瞬间很重要的，就是要回到自己的呼吸，慢慢吸，慢慢呼。
Then get air energy, 공기 yeah, 空气。
所以从
air energy, yeah.
所以从空气中呢得到你的能源。
Yeah, very quickly then body, mind connect quickly. Yeah.
这样子可以很快的身心，然后再有个链接。
Also, emotional energy means in our life, how is my human relationship?
所以我们跟也很重要的就是要知道我跟我周围的人有这怎么样的关系。
So we look at our life, do I have trouble with everybody? Or how is my relationship? Is there love, joy, community? What, what am I missing? Okay, so we have to find that.
然后我们要体验，我们要了解一下我们跟周围朋友的关系啊，周围的人的关系，我们是不是有体验到爱呢，或者是喜悦呢，或者是一种社群的感觉呢？我们要去仔细的观察。
But this is not just the friend in the Facebook, okay?
很重要的是，他不是你的脸书上有多少朋友。
We have to be in the same room.
你必须
with other people.
你必须要跟其他的人在同一个房间里面交涉。
So, in Korea, you know, we have a kind of joke. If you ask a teenager, he go from Seoul, big city, to another city, Busan, and he arrive in Busan and he lose the way. He want to find some shop, but he lose the way.
所以在韩国有个说法，就是一个年轻人呢，如果从首尔呢，要到釜山，釜山呢，然后到釜山的时候，他可能就会迷路，他要寻找路。
But he want to check his GPS map, and the battery run out.
他要用
his phone.
他用他电话找路呢，但是他电话没电了。
So what do you think he will do?
你觉得他会怎么办呢？
What will you do?
你会怎么办？
Huh? Everyone's whispering. I can't hear you.
Ask someone?
Correct. Yeah.
很对。
But usually the teenagers, they look for the phone shop for charger.
所以韩国的年轻人呢，他们的做法却是非常不一样的。他们会找一个手机的店啊，然后问说我们可不可以充电一下，然后希望可以通过充电呢再找路。
So people prefer, I go and charge my phone and look at the phone to find the information, than talk to another human being.
他们宁愿去找一个充电站啊，充自己的电话，多过于找一个人问路。
It's too stressful to talk to another human being. Yeah.
其实他们觉得跟另外一个人交涉是很压力的一件事情。
It sounds funny, but this is actually true.
这很可笑，但是其实这是事实。
Yeah, that means losing human consciousness.
就是说我们呢已经失去我们作为人的意识了。
So use our breath, then make our breath more clear.Come back to our center, Tan Tian, okay? Then using this breath, your heart open up.
所以运用我们的那个呼吸呢，让我们的呼吸变得更清明，然后用我们的呼吸呢，把能量呢集中在我们的能量中心丹田，那我们的心呢就会比较清明了。
Then correct relationships possible. Okay.
然后我们建立跟周围人建立正确的关系呢，就有可能了。
Yeah. And then of course, the very important third part is our mind consciousness. Okay.
第三样事情呢，就是我们的心识。
That means thinking habit.
也就是我们思维的习惯。
How we use our thinking habits.
我们怎么运用我们思维的习惯。
So depending on our thinking habit, which we use, all of us already here, I think, understand this word karma, right? Mind habit.
所以相信大家都知道业力啊，也就是心的习气。
Yeah, depending on our mind habit, how clear is our mind, response to situation, stress, anything, result appears.
根据我们心的清明的程度啊，然后我们就以不同的方式去面对周遭的一个事物呢，然后我们就有不同的结果。
Yeah, so when mind is clear, then universal energy.You get universal energy.
如果你的心呢是清明的，那你就有那个宇宙的能量。
Yeah. So mind not clear, then always coming going, constant discrimination, then everything appear become a hindrance.
所以如果心不清明呢，那你到处呢都起了分别心。所以无论是你的外境是怎么样呢，你都会视之为障碍。
So very important, very quickly perceive what is going on, what is my correct situation, relationship, function.
所以要很快的去关照呢，了解什么样是什么是我的正确的运作关系跟环
relationship
正确的关系跟是正确运作跟正确的处境。
Yeah, mind not clear, then not clear situation get emotional.
所以如果心不清明呢，那外境呢就让你感觉到很有情绪，很多情感。
Yeah, not clear thinking turns to emotion, strong like dislike, then emotional imbalance.
如果心不清明呢，那你的思维呢，就让你的心呢的那个情感有很大的起伏。
Yeah, so that's why we do formal meditation three kinds: meditation to make clear mind, return to our clear mind.
所以我们的禅修呢有很多种功能。第一个功能就是让我们的心呢回到清明的心。
Then we do chanting, calling Buddha name.
我们也有一种 修行方法呢，就是我们念诵佛号。
Chanting will purify our emotional center.
念诵佛号呢，就能让我们的心的我们的心呢变得比较清明。
Then bowing, move our energy for our physical body.
还有第三种呢，就是礼拜。礼拜就让我们身体的能量呢去运作。
So, Zen practice means anything can be Zen practice. Walking, working, washing dishes, driving, everything actually is moment to moment Zen. Means return to before thinking substance.
禅呢，其实就是在无论是你行住坐卧，洗碗架撑。都是可以作为一个禅修的修行的。也就是说呢，就是无时无刻能回到清明的心，思维前的心。
Then return to original substance, then can use whatever is appearing, whatever is happening, correctly.
也就是说，回到你的思维前的心呢，你就能正确的运作。
Okay, so stress can come in many ways, and as I said before, without pressure cannot make a diamond, right?
所以压力呢，可以以很多方式呈现在我们身上，就好像说，如果没有压力，就没有钻石。
So without practice, cannot become Buddha.
没有修行，也就不能成为佛。
But practice means something very, you know, we many times have a wrong idea about practice.
我们往往呢对修行呢有一种很错误的观念。
So practice is not only when we come sit here on the cushion.
修行呢不只是当你来到禅堂呢坐在这边坐禅的时候才叫修行。
Yeah, practice is moment to moment. What are you doing right now?
所以坐禅呢就是从每个瞬间当下你要怎么样运作。
Moment to moment, what is this?
每个当下。你要这就问说这是什么
？Just become clear.
只是变成清明。
Mm-hmm. Then use that.
然后运用那个清明的心。
Whatever your body is doing.
无论你身体在做什么。
Okay. Then any kind of stress appear, we find our way how to face it.
无论是怎么样压力那个外境呢出现在我们面前呢我们也懂怎么去面对。
So I have one technical recommendation.
指导老师有个技术性的一个建议。
I call it, intermittent stress.
有一种方式呢叫做
intermittent, like periodic stress.
就是间接性的压力压力。
What does that mean?
是什么意思呢?
That means constant stress will make us break.
这个持续的压力呢会让我们崩溃。
So if you even you have a really hard time, like you have a very difficult situation in your life right now.
就好比你现在呢有一个你生命中非常艰难的时段。
Find in your daily life some place even 5 minutes, 10 minutes, any place, you can return to your true nature.
也就是在你的每天的生活当中呢，找一些时间，短暂的时间，哪怕只是5到10分钟，然后让你回到你的能量中心。
Yeah. Earlier today, my Dharma sister shared with me, she makes 3 times a day schedule practicing.
所以早些时候呢，有个指导老师的一个佛友呢，他就跟他说，他每天呢固定3次的修行。
That means make an intermittent stress. You're breaking your stress. Whatever you have in your life situation, you break it by putting in this period of come back to original nature.
所以有时候我们的压力呢是持续性的，我们就可以用修行呢去打断这个压力的一个持续性的压力，所以我们就在一天可能就分3次，就通过修行呢让我们回到我们的生命的本质能量。
If you cannot sit for 30 minutes, one time a day, two time a day, three time a day, no problem. You stand up from your office desk, go for a walk around the hallway, 1 minute, come back, sit down, every 30 minutes, okay?
所以如果你不能坐禅半个小时的话呢，其实你可以就设定时间，每一个小时还是每半个小时呢，就去走一下，走一圈再回来。
Go to the toilet, sit for 5 minutes.
可以走去厕所，然后坐一下5分
钟。How many times you go to toilet? 5 times a day? That's how many minutes?
25.
35 minutes meditation for free in the toilet. Nobody bother you. You sit in the cubicle, nobody bother you.
所以你可以一天呢走去厕所5次，每次上厕所呢坐在厕所5分钟，那你这样子呢就一天呢就可以就静坐25分钟了。你坐在厕所里面，没有人可以打扰你。
I'm sorry, you cannot say you have no time.
对不起，你不能说你没时间。
You know, you have time.
你有时间的。
Yeah. Don't make meditation special.
不要让修行成为一个特别的东西。
You make anything special, the special will kill you.
如果你把一个东西制造成特别的东西呢，那特别会杀害你。
Including practice.
这也包括修行。
But you have to do it.
但是你必须去做。
Because you don't have to think about going to toilet.
因为你不需要想，你就会上厕所了。
So Zen means make use of everything.
禅呢，也就是运用我们周围所有的情况。
You go to toilet to shit, use your shit, make it your practice.
你上厕所呢，拉屎，然后你就可以用屎来作为你的修行。
Your family make you crazy.
你的家人让你疯狂。
To find the closet you can sit inside. Closet.
所以你就让你的就去你的找一个你的橱柜。
Anywhere you can sit 5 minutes or go around the block for a walk.
可以找一个橱柜让你去坐下来，或者是在你的家楼下走一圈。
So Zen Master Sung San had one student, this Korean lady, who immigrate to Los Angeles from Korea many years ago.
崇山禅师呢，有一位女的同修呢，她从韩国呢移民到美国的洛杉矶。
She had 3 children, and her husband started a new business in Los Angeles, and they start new life in America as immigrants.
他们有3个孩子，然后她的老公呢在美国发展新的生意，所以他们就在美国过上一个新移民的生活。
Then one day they have like grocery store, supermarket, you know.
所以他们呢在那里呢有一个杂货店啊，然后或者是对不起，就是一个超市，对不起。
Then one day in the grocery store, the husband is working and some black man come.And he want to steal something, and then shoot the husband.
然后有一天呢
with the gun. Yeah.
有一天呢，当那个老公呢在那个超市 工作的时候呢，有个黑人呢，他要打枪，所以那黑人就拿一把枪呢射了老公。
Yeah, so in front of family, the husband dies. The children and the wife see him die in this situation. Yeah.
就也就当着孩子呢跟老婆的面前呢，他的老公呢就被那个抢匪给枪杀了。
So this lady, the wife, don't speak English very well.Immigrant Korean, you know, young children, husband suddenly dies. So huge suffering, big question, you know.
所以他的所以对于女同修呢，她其实是一个很现在非常一个艰难的一个情况啊，因为她自己呢英文也说的不太好，作为一个新移民，然后老公呢又在自己的面前被枪杀了。
Yeah, then she meets Zen Master Sung San and begin practice.
然后他就遇到崇山禅师，然后他就开始修行了。
So much suffering, you know, lose your husband, don't in a foreign country, don't know what to do.
其实有很多的痛苦，因为他在异地嘛，失去了老公，然后也不知道怎么办。
So Zen Master Sung San said, "You must practice."
崇山禅师就跟他说，你必须要修行。
So she practiced really hard.Really hard. Many, many bows, many, many hours. She tried anything, anytime, any place, even running the supermarket, have little children. She tried all the time trying. What is this? What is this? What is my life? What is my life? Why I have so much suffering?
所以她呢就非常的精进，她就不停的礼拜，然后静坐，然后就一个人去忙超市，然后忙超市的时候就很精进、很用功的，然后一直在问是什么、是什么，我的生命是什么。
Then one day she wants to sit, and the children are very noisy. They bother her, playing and fighting, and you know, like, stressful for her, right?
然后有一天呢，当他在静坐的时候呢，孩子呢就很不配合，然后就很吵闹，让他很难静坐。
So she go in the closet.
所以他就躲在衣柜里。
Only place was this small closet where she go in, and she just sit in the dark.
所以他就是坐在一个衣柜里呢，然后就在一个很黑暗的地方坐禅。
And only.What is this?
然后只是在那边问是什么。
And then in the closet, boom.
然后在衣柜里呢，他就开悟了。
She get enlightenment in the closet.
他在衣柜里开悟了。
So she come out and Zen Master check her and she experience her mind in the closet.
所以呢，他就从衣柜出来呢，然后他开悟了，然后崇山禅师也为他做印证啊，然后就是说他体验了真心。
So any of you afraid like, oh, I have to shave my head and become a sunim, then I can get enlightenment? You don't have to worry.
所以如果你唯需要把头发剃光了才能作为法师才能开悟呢，那其实你不用担心。
You first become Buddha, get enlightenment, then shave head, become monk or nun, then no problem.
正确的顺序是你先成佛，然后再把头发剃光，然后才出家。
Help all beings, okay?
帮助世人。
So why this lady can wake up in the closet suddenly?
为什么这位女士呢能在衣柜里开悟呢？
Because she try, non-stop, many months, few years, try. Outside situation, always stressful, look like always get stuck, always suffer. But try practicing.
因为那位女士呢一直尝试，然后无论她在多久呢？几个月还是乃至于几年呢？他都一直的在尝试。如果他离开了修行呢，他的外境呢，其实就是很多的障碍。所以他一直回到修行，一直继续的尝试。
Yeah, not trying only to have good feeling.
他不是为了很好的感觉，然后一直尝试。
Not trying, or I want to be peaceful, or I want to relax, or stress free.
也不是为了要摆脱压力要清静他才去尝试。
Those are like, you know, I want to cut the branches. like trim the tree.
所以那些做法呢，就是说，我为了要清静，为了要安宁，我才去坐禅。再好比呢，就是你在对这个问题的时候呢，你只是在修剪那个树枝。
But no, she try. What am I? Who is making this suffering? Who is making this stress? Where is it coming from? Very deeply, deeply drill in.
所以他就是一直尝试问自己是什么是什么，那个压力是从哪里来的？他就很深刻的去关照自己。
So that's like the water drop, and suddenly this big rock open up.
这好比呢，就是一滴一滴的水呢，一直持续的滴在一个巨石上啊，然后有一天呢，也会滴水到水落石出的。
So that is intermittent. That means periodic. Keep pressure. Then one day become diamond.
这个就是说间断性的，但是它是一直持续着。然后一直尝试，然后有一天呢，他就能突破。
So, we try that.
我们尝试好不好
？Okay, I talk long enough already.
指导老师说太多了。
So, does anyone have any questions?
有没有人有任何的问题
？Any question? Okay.Yeah.
Can I ask a question?
I think so.
My question is, if you talk to someone that's very stressful, you should try, you should practice. You should just and keep encouraging the person to try. Then if the person say, but I feel so stressful, I'm just so stressful. What you say can't help me. So what should you do?
Good question. Yeah. Very important is anytime we meet people who have some problem as a Zen student, my personal rule is I never say you should do this or you should anything.
所以呢，作为一个禅修的禅修者呢，他在无论是帮助任何人的时候呢，他都会很注意的，不要说你应该这样做。
Because I'm not a teacher.
因为他不是一个老师。
Our job is become one with everything.
因为他的任务呢，就是和处境和万物呢合为一。
So it's more important for us to become clear ourselves. Yeah.
所以更重要呢，就是自己要清明。
Then you see somebody have stress, it's emotional. Maybe give them a hug.
所以如果你看到有一个人有压力呢，你就只是去抱他。
You see they don't eat very well, and because they don't eat very well, they're tired, and because they're tired, they cannot think clear, and the problem appear. I call it a 12 links of stress origination.
所以你看到有些人呢，因为压力，然后吃得不好，睡得不好呢，导致这个情况变得更糟糕呢。然后指导老师就会称之为压力的十二因缘。
Then you look and they're hungry. You give them food.
所以看他肚子饿，只是喂他吃。
So telling people something rarely works. That's why I say Dharma talk is not useful.
告诉人家该怎么做呢，就往往是不能见效的。所以有时候呢，禅的讲座呢，其实是没有帮助的。
But your own emotional consciousness and mind consciousness is clear.Then your emotional Kwan simple cell mind connect to this person's suffering.
但是如果你的心呢是清明的呢，你心呢是观世音菩萨的心呢，那你就可以跟你的对象呢合而为一。
Then you help them.
然后你就可以帮助他。
Then later they, he is a good friend.
然后可能就此一些时候呢，他就会说到哦，这是一个很好的，这你是一位很好的朋友。
He will say.How you become so nice? Can you tell me what I should do. Maybe I go meditate with you.
然后他可能就会觉得说，诶，你怎么作为变成一个这么好的人啊？是不是因为你去做禅？可能我跟你一起到禅堂去。
So don't try to change anybody, only yourself.
所以不要去改变任何人，只是去改变自己。
Because people will only follow by example.
所以因为人呢，只会跟着榜样走。
And if your Dharma energy is bright, then they naturally follow.
如果你的法的能量是光明呢，他自然呢就会跟着。
I want to teach meditation, then no student will appear.
如果说你要去教禅，那就不会有学生出现。
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Help. Does that help?
Yes, definitely. Thanks.
Any other question?
有其他的问题？
Everybody now stress free then.
那每个人都没有压力了。
Okay.
好吗？
Good. So, yes.
What was that? Zen Master says life is meaningless. Because I also hear the same thing from another monk from China. He also say life is meaningless. Yes,
right. 所以呢，我们同修呢就说到说，诶，他其实听过从三禅师说到人生是没有意义的。然后他也听过中国的一个出家人呢，也说到说，其实生命是没有意义的，所以要请教指导老师，为什么生命是没有意义的
？Thank you, very good question. So Zen Master Sungsan said, being born human already big mistake.
从三禅师说到说，当你出生为人，这本身就是一个很大的错误。
So before I said the Mark Twain said two most important days for a human, the day you're born and the day you find out why you're born.
所以美国作家 Mark Twain 呢就说到说有两个很重要的日子，第一个日子就是你出生的日子，第二个日子呢就是当你去察觉要询问的一个日子。
So the day you find out why you're born is actually the day you really attain your mind.Actually, yeah. My purpose, right?
所以当你有一天开始有疑问的时候呢，你就会开始去探索自己的新的本质，那才是这是一个很重要的一天。
So between the day you're born and the day you attain why you're born, right? Between those two days, this time in between.
所以当你出世到你证得你的那个问题也就是我为什么要出世这一段日子当中呢
So Zen Master Sungsan said, life has no meaning. Yeah.
从三禅师说到这个生命是没有意义的。
Yeah. No purpose.
没有目的的。
Yeah. Like, no direction.
没有方向的。
Yeah. So what to do?
所以我们应该怎么办
So we have to find this.Why I am born.
所以我们就很重要就是要知道为什么我们到这个世界上。
So all of us here, why do you eat every day?
所以所有人所有同修为什么你们每天要吃东西
Why wake up, get up, eat, go to toilet, go to work, get tired, come home, sleep, get up, go to work, get tired, eat, sleep,poo-poo, pee, and repeat, 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 repeat. And then, you know, suddenly you're like, it's 40, 50 years later, right?
为什么我们人呢要每天清晨早上起来做工吃喝拉撒疲倦休息然后日复一日这样做不知不觉呢四五十年就过了。
So, finding the purpose of our life is our...Bodhisattva, it's our vow, actually.
所以呢，找出我们的生命的意义呢，也就是我们的菩提大愿。
So practicing very important.
修行很重要。
Practicing have some very clear direction.
修行呢，给我们很清明的一个方向。
So if you ask, "What am I? What is this?"
那如果你问自己是什么？
Inside that already is your vow.
在这样子修行的话呢，那心中这里本身就是一个大愿了。
So that is the root.
那也就是根。
Okay, so that's the root you're going to all the time, moment to moment. Keep going. Okay.
也就是我们要无时无刻呢回到我们这个根。
Then Zen Master Sung San said, by doing that, then your life of no meaning becomes great meaning.
如果我们呢一直时时刻刻回到我们的根呢，崇山禅师就会说，那我们没有意义的生命呢，就有产生了很大的意义。
Life of no purpose has a great purpose.
一个没有目的的没有目的的生命呢，现在就有很大的目的了。
Yeah. No direction becomes great clear direction.
没有方向的生命呢，就现在就有清明的方向了。
Okay, so very important is we practice.
更重要呢，就是你要修行。
Okay, so go for the root. How do you do that?
如果我们回到我们的根呢，你要怎么做到呢？
You need your password.
你需要你的密码。
So your password is, if you are doing Huadu, what is this? What is this? Always return to this awareness.
如果你呢是修话头的话呢，那你要时时刻刻要问说是什么是什么是什么。
If you are using Buddha name, Amitabha or Kwan Sambosa or Om Mani Padme Hum or Great Dharani, use it moment to moment, non-stop.Who is chanting Namo Amitabha?
如果你喜欢念诵佛号呢，那你就要无时无刻呢，持着佛号，然后问自己，谁是阿弥陀佛？
Yeah, eating, sleeping, washing dishes, toilet, doesn't matter. Anytime, any place. If you don't have to think and talk, then return to this practicing mind.
所以无论是吃喝拉撒，只要你不需要说话呢，你就可以进行这样的修行。
Then come to Zen Center, practice with Dharma family.
然后来到禅林呢，跟我们的佛友一起修行。
Mm-hmm. Then get energy together.
然后再一起得到正能量。
And see karma more clear together.
然后就可以很清楚的看到自己的业力。
Help each other. Yeah.
然后给相互帮助各位同修。
Okay.
好不好
？Just do it.
只是去做。
I count on you.
我只靠你我就依靠你了。
Okay. Any other questions? Finish.
有没有其他的问题
？Okay, everybody. Long day. So thank you very much for your hard training.
感谢大家出席，大家的心用功。
And see you again soon.
好，希望下次再见。
Namo Amitabha.
Namo Amitabha.